my idea was that I guess the first one was $38, so I'm like, all these wines, $38. And that was my category for the week.
That was my category.
That might be the case. Welcome back. Another episode of Blind Wines. Big thank you, as always, to our friends at Different Drop, hooking us up with this lineup. Now, they're always themed, and what has been happening recently is Lockie will give us a little hint that the boys down at Different Drop have passed on to us. This week, there's no hint, so we're really just flying blind, trying to connect these three wines. Is it region? Is it variety? Is it style? Is it the Miss Marple book that it makes you think of? I don't know. We're going to have to try and figure that out. I've got a question for you guys, and it's kind of related to my own personal experience on this show. I'm now at the point where I actually feel like I can understand some of these things. How comfortable are you just being a little bit of a wanker about it? Because I'm really dabbling with it myself. Where, like, I'll sometimes read a wine list and actually recognize some things, and I'll say, we should have this, and I'll go, why should we have this? And quite often I just find myself going, oh, I don't know, it might taste nice. But in the back of my head, I'm like, because of these reasons. For now, let's drink some wines, which, of course, you can get at 10% off if you go to the discount page on Different Drop. But based on the last few weeks, there's some absolute bargains to be had in there. So make sure you check out the supply on Different Drop.
All right, wine number one. So no hints this week. On what this bracket can be, but looks like we've got a couple of whites and a red.
Being very white winey, nothing really to write home about. If someone opened up a dictionary and there was a description of the colour of white wine, this would probably be a picture.
It's not bubbly, what the fuck? Ah! It just must be that carbonic thing that they were talking about. There's literally, like when I first picked this up, there was literally beads running up the inside of the glass. That's not sparkling at all. Keep your orange juice out of it.
Definitely an aromatic grape variety, like a Riesling or some kind of muscat, Gewurz maybe. Really refreshing palate. It does have, kind of a muscat grapiness on the palate.
Well, that's really cool. Everything about me trying this wine is going, yeah, that's Riesling, and that's really, really fucking good Riesling. But there's some other weird part of me that's like, I don't think it's Riesling.
My number two, this is less filtered. It's a little bit hazier, which is leading me down the path of a more natural style of wine, or at least minimal intervention to keep that color in there without filtering it out too much.
It just doesn't have a lot of acidity on the palate. And I don't know if that's varietal or if it's the winemaking, or I mean, possibly the region.
Texturally, it's really sound. Like with the mineral aspect of it, that's really sound too. The phenolic texture is really sound.
Tastes like Gatorade. Straight electrolytes in that bad boy. Yeah, it tastes like orange Gatorade. Nuts.
It does have a bit of texture, so it feels like maybe the winemaker has tried to use a bit of oak or a bit of like that Nage leaf stirring to build some texture on the palate. I honestly have no guesses on what this could be. It'd be interesting to see what the guys think.
Wine number three, red.
Smells fantastic.
Just cut to Noah, he'll tell you what it smells like.
Really ripe black cherry. It's like ripe red fruits that are just like dripping with juice, you know, like mixed, like a mixed berry, a frozen bag of mixed berries, but it's been left out in the sun for like a month.
It smells a little bit warmer climate. There's some quite ripe fruit there. It's not quite light enough to be a Grenache, so possibly Shiraz, but not from really warm area.
Well, mate, what if I was just about to top off a quaffer? You know, you'd have a quaff with me, wouldn't you? And this is quaffable wine, red. Buy this shit, we'll drink it together.
Yeah, that's yummy. I think it's Australian. It is quite classically made, but there are some examples from maybe someone like Barossa, Younger, or kind of up-and-coming winemakers that would probably make a wine like this that's a little bit more restrained.
But I'm going to guess that these are all Sicilian wines. That's my guess here, because, you know, there's this, like, bright highness of white wine, so I'm really interested to see what Laura and Henry think, because I think we're going to have a very interesting chat here. This is a very challenging wine.
Alrighty, three more wines. Before we hop into them, we have a bracket to try and guess each week. We didn't get any clues this week. Did you guys have any idea? Where'd you go with it?
Look, this could be anything.
Yep.
This out of the wines we've done recently, this has been the most difficult set of wines as far as like to intellectually think about as a bracket that we've done in a few weeks. My gut instinct was Sicily.
I actually went to South Africa.
South Africa?
When I smelled that, I was thinking South Africa too.
Yeah, and it was trying to match wine number one with wine number three, because like growing climate to produce those two styles would be very different.
Mm-hmm. My idea was that I guess the first one was $38, so I'm like, all these wines, $38. And that was my category for the week.
Oh!
That sounds
well,
like
that might be the case.
So wine number one. The only thing I wrote down for this is what gives wine green highlights?
Mostly related to varietal character.
Yeah, okay. and ripeness level too.
Yeah.
But yeah, I was thinking like Rizzer-ish.
Varietally, when I smelt it, I also thought Riesling, but then when I tasted it, it does have some kind of muscat character, so it's definitely a variety from that family.
Beautiful. Lucky, how'd we do?
Wow.
Well, yep, my
okay,
brain is
getting
cold. A Riesling freak!
Okay, so it's a Riesling. It's not South African.
No, it is not South African. It's from Clare Valley,
and
it?
It's off dry.
Get out of town, that's off dry.
It's medium dry. That is a really good wine.
I'm readjusting my guess to say that these are all $25. What are your bracket guesses?
No, these are all Clare Valley.
I think they potentially could be. This red I could see coming from Clare. This one we're going to talk about next. I've got no idea what this is.
Cool, let's get
this. Orange Gatorade, straight up. Like, this is skin contact. It tastes like orange Gatorade. Like, have this after sports sort of thing for me.
Like, everything was really great, but there was just no flavor.
Yeah, I just found it was, yeah, just a little bit flat.
Yep.
It's more interesting aromatically, but yeah, it was just a little bit flat on the palate, and I'm not sure if that is intentional or it's something related to the variety.
Well, I thought it was $38. I wanted 6 bottles of it.
I was 2 bottles for $47.
Yeah, and I was a couple of bottles, but for 25.
Oh, I thought you were going to say 25. My bracket was going to be right for a second there. Fuck, that's cheap too.
Mother block, Chalmers family, Vermentino Ascensia, Ascanica, Pecorino, Falanghina, Moscato Giallo, Grochetto, and Nozzola.
Is Pecorino a
from
place?
The Chalmers people?
Is Pecorino a place? Because I could have sworn that was a cheese. Yep. So what the fuck's it got 19% cheese in it for? What are you talking about? So now knowing what we know about these two, what's the bracket? Is it cheap? Are we doing wines under $30?
Sub-$30 wines.
Sub-$30 bangers. Could be.
I have no idea.
Find out the last one. Wine number three. $38, 6 bottles. That's me.
Oh, I'm exactly the same.
There you go. Hey. You're the magic spear. So you had a 70, I had 38, you had 38. How much was it? It's all under 20. It's all under $25.
Really bummed.
I'm going to say
Alpine Valleys, King Valley, 20, Salmonella.
What? Rosso.
Rosso, man. Alpine Valleys. Not sure on the variety.
So it's probably
it's
a
just blend. It's a
it'll be
blend.
Another red blend.
Another red blend. Well, that's really classy winemaking for such a affordable wine too.
Yeah.
It's under $20. Like, that's unheard of at this quality, like anymore. But yeah, really cool. Billy Button, fantastic winemaker. Joe Marsh is a brilliant winemaker.
Given that my guess on the bracket was a price-related bracket, I'm taking this as a win.
Yeah.
It was under $25 or something, wasn't it?
Yeah, that's definitely what these are.
This
yeah.
is the biggest bargain I have seen in Australian wine in such a long time.
Yeah.
That is obscenely good.
A really cool lineup, and fuck, I do love a bottle of wine that costs you less than $20, so that's that.
Yeah, anything sub 30 right now is a steal, but that's insanity.
Riesling Freak, wine of the week. If you see Riesling Freak on a shelf, just drink it, you'll enjoy it.
It's true.
Guys, thank you so much for joining us. See you again next week. Bye.
Ciao. Let's just do it.